Post our links. And away we go. Alright, let's get some ghost balls in here and then we'll get started. My mic should be working. I didn't really check it, so if it's not, somebody tell me, please. Ooh, we got some usual suspects on here. Hey, what's up, Warrior? Thanks, man. Yeah, I took a look at the scores. Really low. Somebody's what, 30 under after two? Good God, that's impressive on Little Brook Manor. Well, I'm gonna throw Kodiak on here because I think Tyler Duke wanted to play too, just play along. He's not in the tournament, but let's see if he wants to. Tyler, if you're watching, just let me know when you're ready and I guess I can remove Kodiak. And then he'll be able to jump in. Do this. And here we go. Week 38, Barracuda Championship. Oh, what's up, Doubtful? You saw my buddy last night. Go on. Are you talking about Slipknot? Am I safe to assume you went to the Slipknot concert last night? Yeah, I can do that. Hang on a sec, Tyler. Sounds good. There you go. Invite sent. Nice, man. How was the show? They put on a pretty kick-ass show. I'll wait for you, Tyler. There he is. What's up, man? You know, just another week. I'm waiting for you out in the fairway, so. Do I have to invite you in, or how does this work? I just sent you an invite. Oh, and that's a really long show. Nice. Oh, let me check. Yeah, I have mine checked, so we should be good now. If you check it, cool. Let's do this.
All right, I'm home. There you are.
I have to go extremely low.
Yeah, I have mine checked.
I can hear me on your chat. You're watching the stream. There you are. Alrighty.
This is Nevada's course, right?
Yes. Be close.
That'll work. This will be refreshing play after all these frame greens.
I don't blame you. Yeah. I think I went a little long on that. Damn it.
Greens are still tricky, though.
Pretty standard. I'll take tricky greens in medium firmness over what we've been playing.
Oh, yeah.
Quite enough. Not quite enough. Well, that's what I get for starting off with a par. Now I have to get like 13 straight birdies.
Is there a score you're going after?
Well, the leader's at 30 under.
Through two,
yeah. That's really good. Like I was saying, I don't care what course you're playing, that's really good.
Mm-hmm. Doubtful if you're talking about for the web. I have not, and I don't think I'm going to finish my course either. I just haven't been on this game enough.
And you're playing a lot of PGA, haven't you, Rory?
Rory, and I'm playing a lot of MLB. I'm in a super competitive online franchise right now.
Oh, nice, dude. I'd like to get back and play more of that game.
The commissioner made a, put in a $250 cash prize for whoever wins two World Series first.
Oh, nice. That's pretty cool.
So it's pretty intense there. So I'm playing a lot of that, and then I have, five courses in the designer, so I had to start over a new one for web, and it kind of killed me. I mean, I have a course for it, and I would like to finish it, but I'm, seven holes through, and I'm leaving for vacation on Friday for a week, so I won't be making it. But good luck to you, Griffin. Have you finished yours yet? Finishing touches. Yeah, I wish I could have. I still haven't ever done a... Well, I did, a nine-hole contest once. Missed out on U.S. Open. I missed out on Olympics.
You got a couple of years on the tour, though, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, they make the tour, just not in the contest. I don't think my type of design will
really game
in a contest.
Jesus Christ.
I don't think my designs would do that well in a contest because I'm not very
flashy.
I don't have many wow, flashy wow factors in them. I struggle with all the background stuff, the planning and all that. Ooh, this is a tricky shot. I think we need to land this one on the roof.
Yep.
Yeah, bare bones. That's what Canuck says. My courses are bare bones every time he reviews them. I was like, bare bones, but it plays very well, and that's what matters. I'm like, yeah. So, that's what matters to me, if it plays well. I think it's obvious to the designers that play golf and watch golf and stuff.
Yeah, for sure.
And then the ones that are more artsy about it, which if you can combine them, it's awesome.
Ooh, I like my shot, but I got a bad hop, and now I'm gonna go down the hill. Great, that's awesome. Thanks. I'm right on line with it, and it kicks left. I swear to God, now I'm all the way down the hill. One of those days already. I have a 45-foot putt.
That's a tough shot there. Are you putting?
Yep.
Oh yeah, you are. Got a little chip. I could chip it, but it's a weird slope. Not sure what to do with it. I'm such a bad chipper from anything more than 10 yards, usually.
I'm a lot better now, 10 and in. But it gets more than that. I can do 11 decently, but it gets beyond that. It gets a little squirrely.
If I'm 10 and in, I can do all right. Yeah, and then it gets over, and I'm just got no shot.
What's up, Bear fan? I always talking about Brookline.
Oh, I appreciate it. It's be a beast for sure. I actually played the qualifier earlier. Didn't do that.
Oh, I'm
well.
Gonna have. Is that this week? I'm gonna have to do that.
Oh, did you miss signups? You probably missed signups.
Possibly, yeah. I guess so. Slip. I didn't even know I had to sign up for it. I haven't really been around the last week or so, so I missed, if it was posted, I missed
yeah.
it.
Yeah, you might be able to email them.
Do like a light red or something?
Yeah. But yeah, I played it. I played my qualifier at Brookline. It was tough. I think I finished 20 under for four rounds, which wasn't even the best PS4. I think Jerry Klein was 22 under. There's some heavy winds on Thursday and Friday.
That course can be brutal in the wind. I remember we played, it was like 10 to 12 mile an hour, and I think I shot even.
Yeah.
And then I played again in the June Elim. I played against Scruffy, and the winds were a little bit better. I think it was like, you know, 3 to 5 miles an hour, 7 miles an hour sometimes at the heaviest. Or,
yeah.
I don't know.
What'd you shoot in that?
I was 2 under, and he was 4 under.
Yeah.
I think he was 4 under. Yeah, he was either 4 or 5 under. I think I was 2 and he was 4. Either that or I was 3 and he was 5. I lost by 2.
Yeah. Pretty happy with how it's been received. You can, the people that take the time to plan out their shots seem to like it, but I've noticed the people that are, because I was watching some ghost balls and guys were just like flopping it back to their feet and putting it off the green. I'm like, God, I know they're so mad at me right now. But it's really your own fault if you do that.
You just have to be, you have to be really conservative. I think that's what you have to be on that course.
You have to take your time.
Yeah, you can get into a lot of trouble very quickly. Being overly aggressive at chips
earlier.
And different things.
Yeah, I played it earlier quickly and made some really bad mistakes.
Let's see if I can actually get a birdie here. Jesus, I'm a wreck.
You should be able to. It's pretty easy. Had a wedge. I played a Canuck course. People are getting mad at his course. Apparently, one hole, if you're in the fringe behind the hole, it's out of bounds on a green.
Really? That sounds
odd. I don't know if that's true, but...
Why is everything going so fucking long? Is the wind not working? I don't understand this at all. Like, that shot I just had, it was 88 uphill. And so it came out to 90. It came out to 93 yards for the math. And I hit the 9-iron 93 yards into a 5 mile an hour wind. And I have a 15-foot putt over it. I went over it 15 feet. So 5 yards. Like, how does that make sense?
Yeah. 83, 89, 95. Oh, you wafted up.
The 9-iron. So I hit it right at distance. So the wind basically didn't do anything to it.
That's why I don't do the loft up a lot, because I feel like you'll get some random yardages sometimes. It always scares me away. Yeah, Griffin, it's in the forum. Some guy said he did it twice. One time he was just in the rough, and another time he was in the fringe. And it said he was out of bounds.
Whoops. I would be fucking pissed.
Yeah, I think I did OB once on a course, and I only put it there because if you hit it there, you would have literally never gotten out. I really think that's the only time we should use it on this game. Except for like cool little ideas like a road and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, if it's obviously outside the hole, I get it. But within the hole, yeah, I would agree. Like, there was that one course I played where that pile of rocks was there. And I got into it, but I somehow got out. But easily, that could have been just an automatic 12, you know?
Yeah. There's one course we played. It's either, like, really early this season. Yeah, it was, because I actually won there. It was,
I missed that, too.
I forget the name of it.
Oh, man. Not starting off how I wanted.
I forget what it was called, but there's a hole where he had a road right next to the fairway that was out of bounds, and it actually came into play.
Uh-oh. Kick right, kick right, kick right. Nice.
He went left of the trees.
Yeah.
Better angle.
39. Huh, Nevada almost hold his.
Just kind of start putting OB on holes. Yeah, just like make half the fairway out of bounds to make the fairways even thinner. It was last year, Griffin, but it was, I think it was the first tournament of this season because I won it. It was like Blue Oak, I don't remember the name of it. The first tournament of the season. Because I won the first two tournaments of the season and haven't won since.
That'd be nice
it's
to
like
get a
hole
birdie
15
here.
Or something.
Hey, I think I'm gonna actually get a birdie. It's exciting.
Got a better chance than me.
There it is. Drink to birdies. Took me 5 holes, but I got one. Hang on a sec, my phone just rang and I gotta go grab it.
I can't remember the name. It was like Blue something. Oh, I don't know. But it had a really cool finish. Like they had the out of bounds hole and then had that drivable par 4 with the creek really close to where you had to land it. If you missed about like a yard, you go in the water. Scores were crazy low, but it was fun. Was Blue Oak last season? I thought that was the first tournament. It was in October. October 2015.
Yeah, that was the beginning of this season, wasn't it?
Yeah, which is the first week of this season, even though it was...
Yeah, the end of the actual season?
Yeah. I mean, because I only won... Wait. Blue Oak might have been the Wyndham. You might be right, Griffin. Yeah, Blue Oak might have been the Wyndham, which was my first win ever.
And I pulled it. I hope it's
yeah,
alright.
That was the last event before the playoffs, you're right. I remember now. 68. Getting some weird results from this wind.
I'm getting the same thing. I'm getting like way farther than I thought I would be. Like right here, I hit it 160, and I basically landed pin high, and it was 3 miles an hour.
I'm right next to you.
Yeah, I don't understand.
I mainly went left of where I wanted though. The wind was barely pointed that way. Yeah, we agree now. For some reason I was thinking that was the first season. I forget it. I don't even remember where I won them to start this season.
Yeah, Warrior said he's right.
Yeah, it was a Wyndham.
Blue Oak was the Wyndham.
I won a Canucks course. That was the second tournament of the season. The desert course. I don't remember the first name.
What's up, Bear fan? I hope I do. That'd at least get this stream a little more exciting than this fucking shit show 1-under right now.
Nope, missed my putt. Jesus. I started well, now I'm sliding.
Nope, I missed it too. God, these things are breaking way more than I'm thinking they're going to as well.
Ton right. I like this course though, this is solid, like. Medium firmness, but a lot of tricky approaches in.
Yeah, I agree.
Got to land and perfect. This hole should be a perfect 6-iron, I think.
What's up, Atlanta Dust? Welcome, buddy. Welcome to the stream.
Oh, looks good.
Why is the wind not pushing that left to right more?
Ooh, I almost had a live hole in one this stream. That was close. That was really close.
Oh my god, game. I'm gonna be excited if I shoot like 3 under at this point. You know, Nevada messaged me earlier and he was like, "Hey, you playing tonight?" And I was like, "Yeah." And he said something about being able to compete and I was like, "I don't know, I saw somebody shoot 30 under." And he was like, "Ah, you'll have a shot at it, it's a pretty easy course." And I'm 1 under through 8. It's awesome.
Is he gonna show up tonight?
He could. At least have his ghost ball in here, which he always asks for, and I never ever have an option for it. So, why is that ball going so far left?
Some long par fives, though. Both of these have been way over 600 yards. Should be a birdie. It's pretty flat down there.
That ball's going way left for some reason.
Mine is going left.
So annoying. That ball went farther left than my 3-wood did.
Oh, mine actually went way less left than I expected. Looks like it first. You play the WGC yet, Griffin?
The big boy tourney?
I went into it with zero expectations because, I mean, I haven't touched this game. And I actually played really well. I was only one back of Ian.
I needed that.
Nice, good birdie. I was only one back of Ian going into Sunday. I was playing turn-based with him, and then he just took off, and I kind of played bad at the end.
Hot Warrior just said, "I'm going to create the cut. I'm the 70th player." Nice. Or 71st player, I should say. What's the lowest score? Just let me know, so I have something to shoot for.
Hopefully no cut watch this week.
Yeah.
53, 51.
Oh, minus 4. Well, at this point, I'm only 2 under. I have to make a serious run.
Wind just went from 2 to 4 as I swung.
Yeah. Sounds about right.
Actually helped me though. I think I might have been short without it.
I like it. There we go. Finally, something to get excited about. Hey, another birdie.
Nice.
Cheers. Scarpacci, what's up, man? Welcome. It's been a while. Oh, it's gonna be short. Shit. Way shorter than I thought it would be. It's just gonna roll down there a little bit.
Whoa. Took a nice little hop. That must be a down slope. Yeah, you rolled down there, wouldn't you?
Back to back 15 unders, by the way, just in case you were wondering.
Jeez. Who?
I don't even know.
Got it. I had an easy putt, even though over 20 feet away, it was like moved maybe 2 inches.
And I got a left to right or here, or right to left, or I mean.
Yeah, see, I just got down that slope a little more than you, so it was straight.
Doesn't surprise me. It's pretty standard. Nope. God, that thing still broke more than that. God.
I wish we would have played this course in TST this week instead of Firestone.
It seems like it would be a really good TST course.
Yeah, I just... And it's nothing like... The guy that designed it did a fine job. I just feel like Firestone is one of the most boring courses on the PGA Tour. I mean, it is just every hole dead straight with tree line fairways. Like, nothing. And it's crazy to me that it hosts such a big event. And add that to firm greens and some tucked pins. It's not very fun for PFT.
Yeah. Trying to figure out what I want to hit here.
I just threw a little 6-iron, I think. Can't remember. I think that was it.
That wasn't the shot.
Yeah, Griffin, it's just a... It's such a boring course. It's crazy. I mean, I feel like that in real life, too. Like, I never watched this WGC in real life because it, of course, bores me to death. Wow, I just missed a six-footer. He gave you a nice little fairway runoff there.
Yeah. Going. Oh, stop. Oh, God. And away it goes.
It's spinning down to the left. Got the number one stroke index ahead of us.
Great.
Yeah, Griffin, I was actually saying that earlier, like, there's not a single hole that I can think back in November on that course that has anything special to it.
Get in. Yes. Oh, that was a great putt there.
Nice save.
Par save there. Nice little par save.
Had to have it.
Yeah. I need to get on a run here. Oh, be sure to change the driver.
Yeah, this is not a birdie hole here. Not really sure what to hit, what to do.
Oh, what's up, Jay Kessler?
16 is kind of cool. 16. Yeah, I can't even remember.
What do I want to hit here?
Is 16 the... That's the long par 5 with the water. Right? Yeah, that's the only hole that, like, has a look to it on Firestone that actually you could identify. I think that's what you're talking about. Yeah, that's it. 663 on par 5.
That's a shot right there. Golf shot.
Ooh, dang, you stopped that quick. Wow, did you lost something up there?
Yeah, that was a 3-iron.
Okay, I was about to say, whew. Ooh, I just hit it, that huge bender.
Our balls touched. Par 5.
Yeah, and I think Kessler's is just like every other old school American course, kind of. Just doesn't do it for me. I enjoy this, though. This is a nice course.
Yeah, I like the course so far. I wish I was playing better, but I do like the course.
Still got a chance. This is, you can eagle this one. See, 23, yeah, this is reachable. Don't know if we have a good club.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I don't know what club to hit. Nevada's right next to it, so. But when you make the course, you have a little bit of an advantage.
You see what Griffin just put?
Yeah, I like it, Griffin. I'll drink to that.
Yeah, I have no clue what to do. I guess I'm trying to get a 5-wood there, I don't know. 3-wood's gonna just fly over it. That is, I don't know how he got close, because that didn't work.
Yeah, because that's plus 23. So,
he might
251, I guess. Probably lofted up the 5. They probably lofted this up, I bet.
The 5
that's what I'm going to do. Yeah. That's what I'm going to try.
I'm thinking maybe he lofted down a 3-wood. I don't know. Or he purposely laid his drive shorter.
Yeah, he could have done that too. I lofted up. I'm actually sitting pretty good here. I'm going to have a chip, I think. Oh, no, I'll be putting. Well, that should at least be a birdie. I'd like to get the eagle, though.
Oh, that was a 5-wood? How'd you get that there? I lofted mine up, too.
Yeah, I lofted it up 2 squares.
Exactly what I did.
And of course, I aimed it a little bit left because of the wind, and it didn't move. Standard.
That's crazy. Maybe I didn't hit mine 100% because I'm way short.
Then I have this crazy little bump three inches away from my ball. Everything else is perfectly flat.
This my boy played this for fun.
Oh, I lipped it. Just barely. This fucking game, man.
Just doesn't want you to be great.
Thanks, Warrior.
Tapping birdies are always fun.
Yes. I'll always take tap-in birdies, but it does suck to lip out an eagle.
Yeah.
Yeah, designer's advantage. Griffin's hole in ones. I mean, you still got to make the shot, but it does help. When you sit there and design the course and you're thinking through it so much of like what you want to hit, where you want to land.
Yeah, it definitely can't help. But I mean, there's a couple of courses I've created that I still, like, I mean, I struggle like crazy on Brookline. I don't know if I, like, with my 20 under, might not even would have made the qualifier. I have. I won at Crestmont in the European Tour. And I think that kind of, like, soured some people because I don't know why, but I just played lights out that day, that week. I beat Ian by, like, 6 or 7. That was in, like, November. And it was funny because I had, like, the scores I shot in that tournament I had never even touched when I was practicing my own course. Where'd you go on 14?
I am putting right now. I got about a 10-footer, 13-footer. Right to lefter again. So I'm bound to under-read it again. It's been my MO all night to under-read everything. It's a downhill putt, which makes it even worse. Oh, yep, I overread it. So, that's awesome. All over the edge, but never making it. That kind of night, already. I turned my ball trail back on to try to get a better gauge of wind and stuff. I think it's helped a little bit.
Oh, you had it turned off?
Yeah, I had it turned off for a while. Way short. Why did that go so short? The wind is actually helping me. This game sometimes, I just don't get it. I've got like a 500 foot putt. 42 feet uphill, 2 feet. Another right to lefter here. What are the odds that I lip it out? Anyone want to put some money on it?
Only fairway green and sand. I mean, I've kind of done that. But, I mean, I still have rough, like, where the holes aren't, but... And even a lot of Brookline is really wide open with fairway.
I think I had the line too. I just didn't hit it. It's weird I don't have that 77 foot putt in my bag, you know?
Not used to that power. Next hole's pretty fun.
Oh, man. Well, at least I know now I'm not winning anything, so. Makes me feel better. Probably use the aiming circle too. Oh, he said, that makes more sense than I saw his other comment. He said, the ball trail is for chumps. Probably use the aiming circle too. I get it, Scarpacci. I was waiting for you to make some cat jokes tonight. I guess the cats haven't been up here in my lap yet, but I'm sure you got them in, have them in the holster.
Oh.
Ooh, look at that. Close. I don't even know what to hit here. I'm trying to figure it out right now.
It's not a club. I think I got as close as you can get.
Yeah.
Depending on what your wind is at. I almost got up there, but oh, welcome, wind. Had to show up on a hole where you really don't want it.
And it'd be way short, I think.
What'd you hit?
I hit the 3-iron.
Yeah, see, I lofted down the 99 on the 3-iron, trying to get it out of the wind. Still didn't make it.
And I have this putt that I'm barely on the crest of this yellow hill that somehow I'm still on. It's awesome. Get in there. Yes. That was buried.
Nice.
Cheers.
Oh, that's... Just missed a hole out eagle by about an inch. On the next hole.
Thank you, Warrior. I'm way behind you now. Try to catch up here. This is a really, really cool tee shot. Oh,
yeah,
fuck. I didn't even realize the wind... I'm going to be in the rough.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I'm all right. I didn't catch that the wind was pushing it left, and it was 13 miles an hour. Nevada. Oh, he made his.
Oh, he'd hold it out?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, I missed mine by about... I mean, it just went right off the edge.
Like,
jeez,
line of this.
Wow,
how come... Why did that not go farther right off the hill? Oh, man, I should just stop playing this game. I really should. Get in there. Yes. Birdie time. It's a big putt there.
Nice.
I made a slight charge here at the end to come to get borderline respectable.
He's killing me with these, this course is killing me with these 600-yard par fives. Three of them.
Hey, later, Jacob. Thanks for stopping by, man.
Three and two.
Thank you, Doubtful. Thank you, Warrior. Yeah, round's getting a little better, Atlanta. I would agree with you. It is slowly getting better. Once I got the thoughts of actually contending out of my mind now, because going 15-15 is pretty ridiculous. These are the shots I just have a hard time with. So I've got 67 yards downhill a little bit, but into a 12-mile-an-hour wind. And so I never know.
It's a pitch, so it's not going to do much if you're pitching it.
I never know, like...
It's weird with pitches. The side wind is just like any other normal shot, but head and tail wind don't do much to it. That's what I found.
Oh, I see what happened. Seamount for life, period. Was that you who was doing that?
Do what now?
Somebody's posing as me in the chat. Oh, I see what he did. Never mind. My bad. That was goofy Tyler. Okay, this makes so much more sense. So as I'm looking at my chat, it looks like... I see what happened. All right, never mind. Goofy Tyler called me out in his chat, but it highlighted me. So he said, hey, Seamount for life, and then hey. So I thought Seamount for life chatted, hey, chat, how's it going, like type thing. Remember last time? That's happened a few times. I've had guys come in that like acted like me. I thought that's what that was going on there. My bad, Goofy Tyler. What's up, man? All right, back to golfing. Sorry, I'm taking super long. Are you like already teeing off on the next round?
Yeah, I'm on a tee.
All
right. I just hit my tee shot, and I'm about to. We're into the kitchen real quick.
Do it. You got some time. Get in. Nice. Cheers, guys. Well, that was a pretty good run on the backside there. Pretty good run. I mean, really, after the fifth hole, I did pretty well. All right, my minus eight. At least I'm not going to get cut, so that's good. Yeah, I can hear you, Tyler.
Okay, cool. You made birdie on 18?
Yeah, I did. I'm going to post my score here.
Did you hear what I did last week? I played pretty well. PGA would have had a, I think, 6th or 7th place finish, and I just completely forgot to post my scores.
Oh, really? Whoops.
So just wasted. I'm like fringe Ryder Cup right now. I think I'm the first outside looking in.
You better get on your horse.
That kind of hurt.
You have a lot of time, though, right? When's the Ryder Cup? End of the year?
I mean, it's coming. What, September?
Yeah, you got a couple. You got at least another major in front of you. Almost two majors, right?
Yeah, British and PGA, and then Ryder Cups.
After that,
Ryder Cups right after the playoffs, I think. Yeah, there's time.
All right, peeps. Here we go. Round two. Let's have a much better 18 holes here. I'm hoping I can get double digit under. Be nice. I got Nevada's Ghost, Smurf Blade's Ghost. We got John Diesel playing live and in the chat. This is where you want to be on a Wednesday night, Tyler. I appreciate you being here.
Yeah, I mean, usually I have my tournament played, but I remember this week it was a different tournament, so I can jump on. I need to play more anyway. All right, have you hit your tee shot yet?
Yes, I did. I'm out in the fairway now. I'm looking at my 154-yard shot.
There you go. Add the game. Yep. I've got 161. This is a tough shot here. Very tough.
I'm trying to figure out what my distance is going to be here. I always have a hard time gauging these, like, kind of quasi, like, 9:30 winds, you know, 9:30, 10 o'clock winds. Like, how much is it going to affect my distance?
My wind died as I hit, so I might be short. Get up. Oh, hit the rough and got a concrete bounce. Boing.
All right, ball, be good to me. Nope. God, that went way longer than I thought. Wow. Well, I don't know what this putt's going to look like. Ooh, it's not too bad. Left to righter, though. And downhill, which always makes it a bit tougher. Nevada just draining. Right,
he played well, didn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he's top five. I think he's like 24 nice. Under or 25 under or something like that.
Nice. Hit it. That's not a good start.
Oop, nah, too much.
That's a tough hole, though.
It is.
494.
One guy gets cut, Warrior. That would be pretty funny.
Do I play with ghosts? It just depends. I mean, I will. Just kind of depends on the course, the week, all that stuff.
I kind of take advantage of the fact that I don't play enough, and I'm not going to play a bunch of practice rounds to, like, gauge where to go.
Yeah.
Exactly. So, at least I have a general idea. I don't feel like it helps me a shit ton, but it definitely helps.
It's a medium firmness course. A lot of times I don't. And a lot of times, too, I play so early that there's only, like, you know, a lot of times I play at midnight on Friday when Canucks play them and not have ghosts.
Yeah, I play Wednesdays so I know when the cut is, like what the cut line is. That's why I started playing Wednesday nights. Because I have a better understanding of the cut, and I wasn't going to be able to do it Thursday night because it's just too late and I wouldn't be able to do it in time. So I figured if I'm going to be streaming, I at least want to know if it's worth playing the other two rounds, you know what I mean?
I think Griffin was actually asking Goofy Todd if he plays with ghosts, by the way.
Oh. So well, we just answered. We all answered. For
do you play with ghosts, Griffin?
Let's just go around the circle here. I feel like we're in like the lightning round of the podcast.
Ah, good God, I'm not through that 10 feet over the pin. Oh, you were asking me. Yeah, well, answer is it depends. I actually played turn-based this week for the first time with Ian because I'd seen he was like in round three or so when I got on. I was like, this is kind of cool. I have no idea what Ian shot. So jumped in with him and we were like, he beat me by one and I beat him by one and he beat, or two and he beat me by one and I was one down going to round four and then he crushed my soul.
I actually really like playing turn-based. I did it against Smurfblade's Ghost in the June Elim, like I was saying, and I actually really enjoyed doing it that way. It was cool. It added a little bit of an extra kind of layer to the atmosphere, what was happening, mainly because it made me want to outdrive him so I could watch his approach. And I thought that was kind of cool because I felt like I got rewarded for outdriving him, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Which doesn't really happen because if you're playing with ghost balls, they all shoot off at the same time, so.
Yeah. Cool. Killer for me against Ian was, I posted on a thread, I think I probably knocked it closer to the pin 75% of the holes in turn base. And then so he'd be sitting there 20 feet out, drains his putt, and then it's me like 8 feet away. I have to go after him, and then I miss mine half the time. It's like, God.
Yeah, that's gotta be tough.
This is a brutal shot. Because if you land on the fairway, it's going to just either boing over the pin or it's going to bounce backwards on that hill. And you bounce.
I don't know what happened there. Like, I must have just hit it just short. Because watch how he does it on the stream. Look at my hop I get. Are you kidding me?
Yeah. It's because of that, how sloped it is. If you landed 2 yards further, you would have rolled off the backside of the green.
I hate you, Nevada. How about that?
184 on the dot, or it's not going to be good, basically. Let's see. Oh, it's too far right anyway. The wind just completely changed direction. Oh, there it goes. Boing.
Got it. I trapped it in. Cheers, guys.
Alright, so Griffin said check suggestion box for a thread. Oh, you chipped in, nice.
That guy wants ghosts Spanish forever. I like the ghosts, but if they went away, I wouldn't. I mean, whatever. You know, like, I like them there. I think it's a cool feature. But if they added a tournament option to, like, get rid of them, it wouldn't bother me.
Oh, suggestion box. Gotcha. I was thinking shout box. Changes version 2. Tee times. In what world is that even remotely possible?
Did he say his suggestion was that we had tee times?
Because so we can't look at ghosts. Like, that's such a.
It's still a video game, and I still want to play it when I want to play it. You know what I mean? Like, let's be honest, guys. Like,
that's a crazy suggestion. And that would never work. Like, you know,
Who people in Europe playing? Like, what? How are they going to figure that out? What if somebody in Europe wants to tee off and then I'm it's like 3 a.m. for me? Like, that doesn't make any sense.
My hours, like, I don't.
Yeah.
I barely wake up in the morning, so.
That's what I love about the ghost balls is, it doesn't matter when you play. Everybody's playing the same. You know, I can play against you and you're sleeping. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's fucking cool.
That's quite a suggestion. I mean, you can occasionally be like, hey, you know, me and this guy are tied late or something and haven't played around four, let's play together. But
yeah, I mean, that sort of stuff's cool. Actually, Nevada and I talked about that last week or 2 weeks ago, I think, when he played with me, about how cool it would be to, like, pair up with whoever would be in your playing group, like, the final day, and then just play through. Yeah, right, Warrior? I gotta set my alarm so I can get up and hit the range real quick. So I can tee off at 2:46. That's funny. Time for a quick bucket. Tee it up.
Don't get me wrong. Like, would that be cool if, like, theoretically that could happen? Sure, but it can't.
Yeah. We'll have marshals that come on and tell you to play faster.
Sorry, sir, the 257 tee time is right on your back. And
you can't
to get to work in the morning.
You can't just take bathroom breaks, Mark. We're going to need you to play through. We're going to need you to pick up a hole and skip a hole.
Griffin's in the 257. He has to be up at 8 a.m. for class,
yeah.
So he's really needing to do this round.
You're interacting too much with your chat. We need you to skip a hole. What do I want to hit?
Crazy Canucks already 6 holes ahead of you, and he teed off 11 minutes before. He plays his rounds in like 15 minutes.
It's going to be
wow, I'm only 1 under. Oh, yeah, wow. That was my first birdie. Number 4.
Well, this should be a chip in here. I say should be because I just never know.
But no, like, I'm completely cool with ghost balls being taken out for tournaments.
Nice, got it. Chip in again, birdie. Yeah, nice. I'm with you. I think my hope is that they'll have the ghost balls take off in order
at the same time.
But yeah. In order of, like, distance from how far they are from the pin, I think that would be a good balance. But if they just decide to get rid of them in tournaments, then that's cool, too. Like, if they have an option for the tournament creator to do it, I'm all right with that.
Yeah. Well,
I'll probably play a little worse, but whatever. I'm okay with it.
Have the ghost ball take off at the exact same time as when you hit your shot every time.
Yeah, that, too.
Stuff like that. I mean, they're cool to have around, but yeah, they do. I mean, they can be an advantage for sure for people that don't use them, but if you don't use them, it's kind of your own choice, so you can't get mad.
Ideally, they'd give the option to the tournament creator to either have them on or off. And then also add how many you can have. Like, maybe you can just have a max
like
of
that.
One ghost ball, you know?
I have a chip here on 6 that if I miss it, it's going to go about 30 feet past the hole. But I'm just going to go for it because this is a practice tournament for me. So why not?
Yeah, I don't blame you. Alright, distance. Isn't that one of those distance shots?
Oh, it
sure
banged into the pin and bounced off. I guess that's not a bad result either.
Oh, I was close. Uh-oh. I'm not too sure how this is going to go. Oh, I just got dropped from my game. That's not good.
Nice.
That's always ideal. Alright, I'm back online. Resuming competition. Sorry guys, actually I'm gonna take this opportunity to fill up my drink. I'll be right back. Doing Captain and root beer tonight. It's actually pretty good. Alright.
I've been on a IPA tear.
Oh, nice.
Alrighty. Whew.
Nice. I made it again. Cheers, everybody. Jeez. That's three chip-ins in a row.
Warrior said, I need to learn the nine iron chip. I absolutely do, too.
Yeah, it completely changed my chipping game. I mean, anything inside 10 yards has a good chance of going in, barring wind and some other stuff. But distance-wise, it's so awesome.
I've seen people dominate with it, and I just like haven't practiced it, so I'm scared to use it.
Yeah.
What do you do with this shot?
Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing. Somebody's really close, too.
How? It's a downslope into the pin, and then...
Yeah.
I don't know. You might have to land on the rough perfectly, but then you risk water. Give it a run. There's a 362, so it's E1, 60, 60, depending on what you need, I guess.
Alright, be the club.
Be the club.
I like it.
Oh, get up, get
stop,
up.
Stop.
Oh, that's tough. Look where I am.
Oh.
Another yard, and that rolls right down to it.
Yeah, look at that. Brutal. That is brutal.
And the God, come on, game. Really?
Oh, that's brutal, dude.
Did I go through the pin?
All right, let's take a look at the second hitting the wrong button. I've been on the receiving end of that way too many times, so if you want to throw your controller, you can go ahead and do so. I won't judge you.
That was the old through the whole thing that Brighttail complains about 24/7.
Yeah. I had that happen a couple weeks ago, too. Same thing. Doesn't make any sense.
It claims it happens to him on putting all the time. Which I think that can only happen. You're blasting your putts.
Get in.
Going
yes.
On, Dr. B.
Cheers, guys.
You're killing me this round.
Hey, what's up, golfer dude? Welcome. Strav. Hey, man. Sorry, I didn't even see you jump in here.
What'd you shoot that one? 8 under?
Round one was 8 under, yes.
I was 13, so you're only one back in me now, total. Cut into the lead quickly. I'm struggling with these pins. How does somebody shoot 15 under in this?
I hope I can continue this birdie trend.
I got a birdie, that's for sure.
You must have moved back the tees on this one.
No, this one was 600 yards too. It's the first one on the back that's reachable last time. The other three were all 600 plus. Go in.
Alright.
Nope, too far. Good God, I'm hitting some poor shots.
What do I hit here? I got 64 yards.
Poor shots from here. I can't putt anymore. Another missed putt. Well, it officially looks like I finished better. I'm gonna finish better in the WGC this week than I would in this tournament.
That's good. At least you picked the right one.
I'm 42nd. Well, it can't, doesn't really count because people play more holes than me. But...
I just missed that. That thing went hard left to right. Good God. God damn it. Leave it up to me to do something stupid like that.
The bus just parted. Par 5 with a pitch in. Well, this is a fun pin.
I'm assuming I have a bad angle at it. Oh no, never mind. I got a decent angle.
No. It's actually like kind of hard not to get this one close. Just gotta use that slope. On the left.
Yeah.
41. The wind keeps going up now.
Yeah.
And now it goes back down. God damn.
Mine's at 7.
Yep, I found the false front. Mine was at 6, jumped up to 8, so I adjusted for 8 and I hit, and then it went back down to 6. Man.
Oh no, stop. Ooh, mine stayed up somehow, some way. But I didn't hit it far enough, though.
See, this is the shot where I don't know what to do. 17 yards, if I flop it, I risk knocking it back to me.
Yeah.
No clue what chip to hit. I feel like a pigeon wedge chip would work. Let's try it. Nope, that barely got to you.
Come on, ball. Son of a bitch. Oh, man. It's like Mark 101, how to derail a good round. Just blow a 6-foot putt and then just lip out a fucking another one. So awesome.
Well, Warrior, the green like that would work, but there's also some really tiny greens out here, too. I couple the par threes. Oh, well, I'm glad I saved that 30 footer for bottom hole. So, this will be another hole that could work with firm too. A couple of them are pretty nasty. It's a tough shot anyway. 31. Where you at, wind?
Ooh, go in, go in! Oh, so close. Sorry for screaming in your ear, ooh, but that thing was very, very close.
Yeah, well, I feel like I'm about to miss another 8-foot birdie putt here. Let's see. Yep.
Lame.
Crazy bad.
Cheers, guys. Hey, what's up, Nevada? Well, my first round, I shot 8-under, so that wasn't all that exciting. And I started off really hot this round, but I've actually, other than that shot right there, the last three holes, I lipped out, I just barely missed an 11-foot putt, and then I missed a very makeable 6-footer to go par-par. I was actually, I was 6-under through 7.
Well, your course is killing me this round, Nevada. Not sure why, but I'm not hitting anything close. This looks good, though.
Come on, wind.
A little long.
Ooh, I'm snug. Boom. Birdie time, cheers. I really like the course, Nevada. Actually, Tyler and I were already commenting on that. I do really like the course, so nice work.
Yep, plays good. Have you played this course in real life? Do you get too often? Figure you know a lot about it since it's...
Is this an RCR?
Yeah.
Nice. I didn't realize that.
Yeah. I think that's why it plays so well too.
Yeah.
People do RCRs, right? They usually play really well. Unless they're firmed up for no reason.
Agreed. I like it because even though it's medium, you still have to make good approach shots. Like you can still get into trouble even though it's medium firmness. Yeah. And there are some gimme putts, but there's also some tougher putts if you're in the wrong spots. So it's a good balance.
He's moving on me like crazy. Oh, give me a hole out. God, watch this.
Oh, it's close. Stop. Shit, this is not going to be a fun putt, I already know it. It's not as bad as I thought, but still. These tricky downhill putts that break, like, at your feet. And then they're straight the rest of the way. I hate them.
Glad you didn't play Firestone. I've never had so many 6-foot minus 5 inches putts.
Those are brutal.
I mean, just time after time. Because he was trying to represent, I guess, that, you know, a lot of all the screens are very much back to front, but I have a hard time believing they're that
smart. Oh my god, I just burned the edge again. Son of a bitch. Brutal. Yeah, this is the one we can. This is the one we can make, isn't it?
Yep. This time it's 245, 248.
This time into the wind too.
Still want to know how Nevada got so close in round one. What you?
Yeah, right. This one will be a little bit tougher because there's nowhere to roll. And Smurf went short.
Ooh, I'm trying to roll.
I have a feeling this is going to be more of an eagle chip opportunity than anything.
I lofted mine up. I maybe didn't need to. Probably while I was short.
Happened there.
Apparently playing live with you has cured my glitch. For some reason, the last 2 weeks, I've had that glitch door they used to have where my golfer won't take back his club like 3 times in a row.
Oh yeah, I had that. I had that for a while, and then it just magically got fixed. I don't know what happened, but I had a couple weeks in a row where I would swing a lot, and he would just either barely bring it back, or he wouldn't bring it back at all.
Yeah, mine keeps just barely going back, and this is the first round I've played without it. And it's really annoying for flop shots because, you know, you're so focused on timing.
Right.
And then I keep not knowing when I'm actually going to bring my club back. So that was pretty tough. I hit some bad flops.
Great. Now I have a 7-foot putt 3 inches downhill and going left to right. It's just what I wanted to have for my birdie. This thing is going
to
break.
Man, I wish you were able to sign up for open qualifying. Hopefully if you email him, he might let you in. I don't know.
Get in there. Yes. Oh, I drained it. Whew. It was a tough putt.
Give him a hole out. There it is.
You got it?
Yep.
Oh, nice.
That comes so close.
All of a sudden, you're 7 under.
Yeah. What am I?
Nice shot, man.
Yeah. Played my last 5 holes 4 under. Or 4 holes 5 under.
Ooh, plus 8 through 9. That's brutal. There's only one way to go from there, and that's up there, Goofy Tyler.
fairly new to the game, Tyler.
It's true.
Give me that ball. I am very streaky, that's for sure. When I start missing putts, I miss a lot of them.
Damn it.
It's so weird how much confidence has to do with putting on a video game.
I got another slippery one here. Another slippery one. This is going to be a speed putt.
By the way, golfer dude, we did pretty well on our... Miss it. Oh, just right. We did pretty well on the... US Open predictions, didn't we? And are in the C-Mount chat, as I said, DJ was going to win, and we both said Sergio would be in contention. Actually, yeah. I put 10 on DJ, $150.
I'm so glad that whole stroke fiasco didn't cost anything. What a black eye that was, for fuck's sake.
It killed the entire tournament.
The last two hours, that's all they were talking about. It just completely ruined it.
Everybody played terribly. Did you notice that?
Yes.
It's like that happened, and they told everybody about the penalty, and it's like everybody just forgot how to play golf. It was bad, because the tournament was really fun before that. And
right.
It's like it just killed everybody's momentum. But I'm glad DJ won. I mean, obviously, I would have preferred Sergio, but he was my second choice for sure.
He's been due. He's had enough heartbreak. It's cool to see guys like that win it after, I mean, last year and some of the other tournaments, he's been barely in and blown and shit like that. So
he's so good, too. It's just crazy.
His girlfriend's hot, too, which makes it awesome.
his drives doesn't even make sense. Yep, golfer dude, that was a Sergio moment after he holed out in Walker. It's like, oh, he's gonna go off now, and then he bogeyed like 12 and 13. He birdied 13, he was one back, and then he bogeyed three straight.
I'm having a hard time adjusting to these greens a little bit too, because I keep thinking they'll roll out a little more than they will, and they won't. And I'm stuck with 15-foot putts instead of 8-foot putts.
I got up at 7 a.m. Sunday morning sucked. That's when he played so bad.
Yeah, those first couple rounds must have been brutal playing so much.
Yeah. I just remember how tough it is for you guys to watch the British Open over there.
All right. The timing.
Yeah, they tee off at 3:30 my time, so I'm almost better off staying up to watch at midnight on the West Coast.
Yeah. Get in there. There it is. Buried. 10 under. Cheers.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah, nobody talked about it, but Lowry put together an impressive choke job. He missed.
Yeah, he did.
Like four straight pars from inside 5 feet.
And he just disappeared too.
Yeah. I didn't expect that either. He seemed like the type of guy that wouldn't bother him.
Yeah.
But apparently he did. What is this putt, Nevada? Got a triple breaker from 7 feet? 9 feet? I snuck it in there. Man, 14 under through 17, that's impressive.
Yeah.
These have not been easy fins. This hole is so far downhill that I don't know if driver's too much club.
Jeez, this thing is a big bender from left to right. Holy crap. This is going to be a...
I was on the wrong side of the cup. Trying to move around and find you. The green.
Oh, get in there. Oh my god, it just grazed the edge. I mean, I'm 10 under and I have 3 balls that hit the fucking edge of the cup. Ah, man. I really, by the way, Nevada, I love this 17th hole. It's fucking awesome. I mean,
yeah, it's great.
It's an RCR and everything, but it's really cool.
Did you have to make 17 over here just like because of map transitions, or is it really that big of a walk or drive? Because
oh no,
it's like way away from 16.
Yeah, I should have gone down a club.
Oh, you hit driver.
Yeah.
I hit 3-wood and it still might go out. 335 yards.
So short. I hate this game out of the rough. It's so fucking dumb.
Yeah, that's what I figured was it was just because of the plot. I'm about to say that's a hike from 16 to 17 straight up the hill. I had that problem on. I've been kind of trying to recreate my home course, and the way it's routed won't fit on the plot.
Oh, I drained the chip. Yes, I just flopped in. Cheers, guys.
Oops.
Wow.
I wonder how many putts you're gonna have this round.
Not many. I have 3 chip-ins. That's actually 4 chip-ins.
Yeah, that's 4.
Thanks, Nevada. All right, par 5. Here we go. Thank you, golfer dude.
This
thanks,
might
Atlanta.
Even be reachable. I don't know if it'll be reachable, but it's downhill and downwind.
Man, it's 10 miles an hour for me. I got a good drive. 355 yard drive. Jesus Christ.
Yep, I'm right behind you.
I think it's reachable.
350.
This is definitely reachable. Four.
Yep, oh, easily. Not even with 3-wood.
Yeah, I might have to go down a club.
242. Even 5-wood is going to be a lot.
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know what to hit.
Well, thanks for the compliment, Warrior.
Yeah, I think I'm going to try to run up a 3-iron and see if that works.
I'm trying to figure out the distance here. It's about 15, 16.
Yeah.
Downhill, it looks like.
Yeah, I'll show you the way. I pulled it a little bit. That's too much because of that rock hard bounce.
Yeah, look at that. Man, that thing runs.
That's best effort of the pop.
I try to do a lofted wood is what I'm hitting. Let's see how this goes. And it's probably gonna be too far. But who knows, might land softer. It did. Come on, curve right. And it didn't go as far right as I thought it would on the green, but I'm gonna roll off I think where you were.
I went 34-27.
I got an eagle putt here. Let's see what I can do with it. Worst case, chip in birdie, I hope.
Quite the turnaround.
For you, yeah.
Yeah, I put up right now with that. 7 pars. Managed to kind of come around. No, I know 27 is not bad. That's good. 34 was not good.
Oh, I'd love to drain this. Oh, it was close. Well, tap in. Boom. 12 under. Cheers, guys. It's a good round. Really good round. Really, really good round. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Thank you, golfer 24 dude.
24 under.
So now I'm 20 eight. Under. I'm 20 under for the tourney.
I'm 8 under first round. Himself.
The man, the myth, the legend, Nevada Ballin.
Creator, of course.
All right, guys. Two rounds in the books. Time to tee off on round number 3. Are you going to keep playing, Tyler?
Yeah, I'm good for another. Cool.
Let's do it. Thanks, everybody, for watching tonight. Continuing on to round 3. Currently 20 under. The leader is 30 under. So I'm not even sniffing that. But, I was just trying to get top 10, top 15 stuff, you know. I think it's going to take for me to have really 4 really good rounds in a row to get in contention in any week, whether it's a secondary tournament or not. I've only put together 4 straight rounds a couple times. One time I finished 8th or 6th or whatever a couple weeks back. And then the other time, it didn't even count when I played the Masters. I played really well when I was just playing the Masters for shits and giggles.
Salem, Oregon. Nice. I'm leaving tomorrow or Friday for...
Oh, nice.
Sanibel Island, Florida. Down west of Miami.
You are?
Yeah, on Friday morning.
That's pretty cool. I don't have any vacations planned at this point. Well, I'm going to get to Seattle mid-August. Going back home for a long weekend. That's all I have planned at this time. My girlfriend's in Ireland right now, so.
Nice.
Yeah.
I imagine this will be the last family vacation for me. I'll be out of college, and who knows where I'll end up.
Yeah. You're just an empty book right now, Tyler. Okay, let's actually birdie this hole. I haven't birdied this hole yet.
I'm not going to birdie it. I've got 40 feet.
Alright, so 169 is my distance.
Tough opening hole.
Alright, ball, be good to me. I like the line of it a lot. Yeah, roll on up there. Sweet. That's a good shot for me right there.
Nice, and you landed just on.
Yeah.
I landed on the fairway and boinged over the pin.
This should be a putt I make. Looks like it's going to be left edge. Yeah. Get it. Boom. Birdie time. Cheers, everybody. Hey, Goofy Tyler, at least you came back. I think you said you were plus 9, weren't you? I had a round last week where I double bogeyed number 1, and then I ended at 11 under.
Nice.
It was pretty awesome. Alright, Nevada said some of these pins are going to be brutal. Saturday pins. Well, that's good. I'm glad I got that birdie then. Sounds like it's going to be tougher sledding. Or I can just play really well and maybe catch up on the field a little bit. Make up for my average first round.
Second pitch in with the pitching wedge. I'm pitching well.
That's good. Oh, you're not live with me anymore.
Not really.
I just realized that.
I got you up. front of your live frame. That should be it.
Yeah, I got it. Add the game. I'm doing it now. All right, there we go. Cool.
Oh, God. This is a rude pin, Nevada. Yeah, tree trouble on a par 3. Have to work the ball a little bit. Nasty.
Ooh.
I don't know what to do.
Get in there. Yes. Birdie time. Cheers, guys. BFP right there. Ooh, that's a brutal pin. Are you just talking about this one on number 3?
Yeah, number 3. Very nasty.
God damn you, Nevada. Oh, I see what Smurf Blade did. He played that slope. Still, it's not even the play. Look at that thing. It's going to go off the green. Man, it's brutal.
I don't know if I want to try to land it on the green.
Yeah, I'm going through the same thought process right now, too.
Because you have to land just perfect. Or if I want to try to bounce it off the rough short. I'm gonna try off the rough short. Hang on for me.
Wow. My shot was really good. That thing did not take the type of hop I was expecting where it hit. Watch my stream. Watch this. Dunk. And it just, like, dies.
Nice.
I like it. I'll take it. I don't get many breaks like this.
Mine did whatever you said Smurf did.
Blame Jack Nicklaus. He designed it.
Jack Nicklaus,
I'll let him know. I'm going to write him a letter.
He has made some really nasty courses, man. He got a couple around me that are just... Some of the holes you're like, God, he was being a dick.
Get in there. Oh, I lipped it. Damn it, that's a steel birdie hole too, and I lipped it out. God damn it. I'm really mad at myself because that was too good of an approach shot to lip that. Shit. Ah. Alright, back to it.
There's a...
Elephants buried under the greens.
Yeah, there's a Bear's Best course near me, which is like a combo of all his toughest and best designed holes across the world.
Right.
And it nasty.
Golden Bear.
What to hit here? Don't know. We're going to try something.
Do it.
Oh, no, I pulled it. Can't pull it.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what I want to do.
Turned out all right, I guess.
That didn't end up too bad.
Actually, perfect. Doesn't move an inch.
Yeah, I'll take it. I think I followed your lead there.
Yeah, just landed right over and spun it. Yeah. Should have a dead straight foot.
Looks like it. I'm going to check it real quick, but it looks like it's maybe left edge at the most. Yeah, this thing is it moving. Boom. Birdie time. Cheers, guys. God, that number three hole is going to piss me off. I got a good break on that hit, on that approach. And that's not a birdie hole either.
No. Yeah, see, these are not very easy pins. I'm a fan of a day that's tough pins myself. On fictional courses, I usually make it Friday. I usually make Thursday really easy and then Friday tough. 43.
That. Oh, ooh. Did that go in? Nice. Nicely done.
Pretty kind of lucky in a way.
Hey, but I'll take it. Nice shot, man.
Thank you. I landed a yard short of where I wanted to.
I got some lightning and thunder right now in the area. Monsoon season. Monsoon season is here.
That's a golfer, dude. Yeah, I mean, it was on the line I wanted. I didn't want to get that concrete bounce, but that works if it hits the pin. Got a live look in it. Mark Foley's ball here.
I'm trying to figure out what distance I want to hit this. Follow your lead, maybe? Look at this. Oh, just a little right. Oh, well, I'll take it. It's a good shot.
Nice. Right off the rough.
Yeah, I was hoping to land soft, kind of how you did. And then just trickle it on up there, which is what I did. You just had the line, that's all. And I have a downhill slippery putt. Good God, this thing is going to break a lot.
Oh, I just hooked a tee shot. Straight into the heavy rough. Oh, wait, no. It just hung on.
Come on, get in there. Get in there. Ah. Oh. Stop turning. Shoot. Yeah, quarter inch of rain in the patio. It happens quick, man. It happens so fast here. And then, like, an hour later, it'll be gone. It'll be kind of damp outside, but you won't even guess it even rained. But there's nothing better than after it rains and you walk outside and, the air is so crisp. It's pretty badass.
That was not a good shot.
Short.
That was pretty weak. That's me being so used to firm again, where I think the downwind's gonna make it just bounce like crazy.
Yeah. I don't know what to hit right here. Yeah, I'm kind of in the same spot you are. Now let's see here, Wind. I need you.
That's tough.
Ooh, I like it. That'll play.
Not very nice.
I have played Arizona Grand, yes. It was a while back. It's been probably 5+ years at this point. I remember it being a fun little track. It's a little resort track, isn't it? Yes, the 18th hole is pretty solid, I will agree with you. This is a brutal pin.
Yep, I flew mine too far. Still good, I mean, it's on the green, but needed to land that upslope. Nevada, when you're gonna design a good Wolf Creek.
I hit it exactly where I wanted to, and I did not get the hop I wanted, but I'll take it.
Oh, you just got up there. Wow, that was
awesome. Yeah. I thought that was gonna hit a little harder than that and jump up there, you know what I mean?
God, I keep overreading these.
Well, the Mariners lost.
They've been doing that a lot more lately, haven't they?
They just tanked it. Their June has just been awful.
Now the Rangers are like the best team in baseball, so...
Yeah. They can't lose, and the Mariners just can't seem to win. They've had a lot of injuries, too. They've lost 3 of their starters, our rotation. 2 of their position guys got hurt. They lost their backup catcher tonight, so. But that doesn't mean you can go 7-20 for a fucking month.
Is Felix still out?
Yep, he's out still. He's been out for a while.
Yeah. Felix is my ace on my online franchise.
Oh, really? Nice. The king.
Yep.
Come on, ball. Get in there. I overread it. I probably read that for a downhill putt, but it was uphill. Yeah, we are tortured, I would agree with you. Especially the last 15 years have been brutal. Jeez, this is going to be a long hole. Very, very long hole. 630 yards into the wind.
It ended up being too bad. It's just I hit sand wedge for my third shot. I haven't heard anybody at 4,000 off of it. Best I've seen is still Ian's 38. And I think second right now, that's 33. Pretty tough.
That wasn't what I wanted. Man, the wind knocked that down way more than I thought. This game sometimes, I just don't get it. Well, you can try to chip this in. That'd be nice. Uphill a foot. That's good to know.
Yeah, Griffin. You got no chance without the ghost.
Go in. Oh, it's short. It was going right in, too. Damn it. That should have been made. I almost had another one of those where my finger slipped off the stick. Were you watching a couple weeks ago when I pulled back like an inch and my finger slipped off and it recoiled back up and he hit it? And I hit the ball like 15 yards. I almost just did it again.
Whoa. Why so far left?
Hey, what's up, Yaters? I'm 20 under starting this round, so I'm currently 24 under for the tourney.
Griffin, when did Splittail show back up? I thought he left. Who was that? Like, was that Rick Wilson or something? He used to be on the forums a lot, and I haven't seen him any lately. Another burn edge.
This is a tough round. I can understand why you could blow up on it.
You're gonna have a fun putt there.
Yeah. Downhill, left to right. Makeable, but not easy, just because of the speed.
Oh, he just showed back up to say that. Gotcha. Cause yeah, I hadn't seen him.
Get in, get in. Nice. Cheers, guys.
I heard I have a 6:24 a.m. tee time next week. I'm not looking forward to it.
I just hope I get up in time to hit the range, you know?
Yeah.
My brother and I use that tin cup line all the time. Where he's like, time for a quick bucket. Tee it up. When he wakes up after getting just shit canned. It's awesome.
He was my first TGC friend of Xbox. I wonder who my first PS4 friend was. On TGC.
Alright, let's try to make this. What do we got for a putt? Uphill 7 inches.
Oh, you're right next to me.
Yeah.
But I got a putt mom. Ooh, that turned more than I thought.
Yeah,
Here, I'm about to disqualify myself for the tournament here with a chip. Actually, I'm not. This is too close, and I end up missing it.
Get in there. Oh, you son of a bitch. Damn it.
Ooh, here's a fun one. Oh, my.
What's up, Nevada?
Holy cow.
Wow. What do you even do here? Land it short and hope to God you,
That's nasty. I will take that all day.
Ooh, I just tried to slam dunk it.
I left myself a 4-yard chip.
Damn it, I have a 12-yard chip.
It's one of these again that if I miss it, it's gonna roll forever. I'm just gonna try to slam it in there.
Too far. Shit. Son of a bitch. God damn it. Yes, I made it. Wow. Cheers, everybody.
Just slam it in there like I did.
Yeah, I figured the wind would take it just far enough left for the break to take it right the last couple of inches, and it did exactly what I thought it would do. Yes, trust me, golfer dude. It's the first thing I hope they fix on TGC2 is the goddamn wind affecting chips so much. Obviously, it's going to affect it a little bit, but it's so overpowered. It doesn't even make sense.
I've never in my life seen a chip affected by wind.
Yeah, I never have either. I would imagine
just wind in general.
Physics-wise, it would be a little bit, just a touch, like a hair maybe.
Yeah.
But you shouldn't even notice it.
I play in 10, 15 mile per hour wind in real life all the time and barely notice anything with my ball flight.
Yep. I feel like the wind it should be doubled. The number should be doubled for how much it affects the ball.
Yeah. I'm here 50 miles per hour. You have to aim, like, in the woods.
Yeah. This shot.
God, I've overplayed every putt.
Ah, flew too far. Ah, I like that ball too, dang it. Oof. Another one of these downhill, just left to right benders. Yeah, 1 yard too much, you're right.
Yeah, I did. I did go for dude. Pretty funny.
Uh-oh.
He did his...
Get in! Ah, oh, just by it.
Miguel and El Jimenez dance.
Well, I started off pretty hot, and then I've just gone stagnant. Three straight pars. I had a chip I should have made. I had two balls that touched the cup earlier. God damn it. So annoying.
Whoa, just sliced a 5-wood into the bunker. This is
That's true, Yaters. No red numbers. I would agree with you.
I'm not even gonna birdie this little easy hole. Jeez. I'm dead over here.
Yeah, everybody went into the bunker.
Oh, I got lucky. Oh, I almost holed it for eagle.
Wow. Yeah, I thought I'd fly a little farther. Dang it. Oh well.
Well, red is good in golf. When you get into red numbers, it's under par.
It's true. So I think he was referring to red being bogeys, I think is what he meant. Under scorecard, I think red bogeys, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yaters, thanks for the follow. I didn't realize you weren't following me yet. Thanks, man. Alright, I got this weird...
Cool, I cannot buy a putt. Brutal. Just brutal. I see now why. That yellow slip didn't show up as yellow when I was putting. I was extreme break.
Well, I'll take my bird. Cheers, guys.
Better than me there.
Here, hang on a sec. My sister's calling me, so I don't know. It's kind of weird for me, so hang on a sec.
All right. Losing my voice. Well, yeah. So if you're in financially, it's also
right,
if you're going in the red, that means you're going negative.
Are we still talking about this red thing?
Yeah. So I guess that's why it makes still kind of makes sense both ways.
Anyway, I was gonna say it's not odd that my sister calls me. It's just it's late, so that's why I was like, all right, I gotta check this just to make sure. But nah, she's cool. She was just driving home, wanted to chat.
Nice.
But Smurf almost drained that.
Not hit well. I guess it's all right. See if I can finally make a putt. Poor putting effort for me, which has kind of been how things have gone a lot lately.
I don't have any clue how this ball is going to react to this wind. I'll probably be way short, I bet, but oh well. I'm hitting it anyway. Oh, look at this. It is all over it. Love it. Whew. Well, I was hopeful that's what would happen, but I was not expecting it when I hit that ball. But that thing almost went right in the stick. That's a dart right there. Cheers, guys. Illuminati confirmed. I'm just getting caught up with the chat. Ooh, this wind starts to get pretty brutal too. I can understand this being a tough round because of that alone.
Oh no. Bounced it off the fairway and I got a huge hop.
Oh yeah, I saw that.
Put a straight downhill, but it also says that it's dead straight. Do I trust that?
Oh, I got the hop I wanted. Yes. That is exactly where I wanted to put it. So good. For as frustrating as this game can be sometimes, there are times when it actually works out the way you want it to, and it's pretty awesome. 25 mile an hour winds? I don't think I've ever seen it that high. I've seen it 21, 22, but I've never seen it 25. That's ridiculous. That's like borderline unplayable in this game.
I would not play.
Mm-mm.
Because it'd just be stupid.
You would be, like, scraping to reach par fours in regulation. If you're into it.
And it's funny because 25 miles per hour in real life is, like, it's strong. But you can play in it.
Yeah.
Fine. That's like the Masters this year was around 25 to 30 a lot in real life. But on the game, it's like not playable. It's like hurricane winds. Like
yes.
See, I have maybe the nastiest putt I've ever seen on TGC right here.
Chips were moving 15 feet. Oh, it's so good. But the wind's okay, guys.
I'm on the back of the green. I mean, this is nasty. I don't know if I get this within 10 feet.
Hmm. Oh. I need you, wind. I need you. It's coming back around now. Jeez, I'm way short. Oh, I got a hop there. This might work. Look at this. Just wait till you watch the stream and watch what happens to my ball and look where I stop. Like, what else am I supposed to do right here?
Yeah, you almost got... You didn't get back as far as I did.
And it was uphill.
About a 3 foot.
Wow. This might be pants off backflip time if I make this shit. Where is Doily tonight?
I haven't been around.
Busy banging dudes, probably. Oh, it's got a line on it. I don't think I hit it. It is right on. Look at this, guys. Go in. Go in. I fucking drained it. Oh, my God. Are you serious? Cheers. Wow. I don't even know what to say right now. I'm going to go ahead and save that. Wow. Should I just do the backflip anyway? Alright, hang on. Here we go, I'm gonna do it.
Better than most.
There we go. It was a quasi back roll on the couch. I just thought in the stream. There you go. You guys can tell. You guys can all tell Doyle that he missed. He missed it. Wow, that was fucking insane. But at least I know I can hit driver on this.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll replay it. I'm getting a request to replay. Let's do the replay. Here it is, guys. In all of its glory. Look at that fucking putt. That is so good. Alright, we're going to do it one more time. Thank you, golfer dude. And I understand that reference. That was amazing. Yeah, I don't know how it kept rolling, Bears fan. It was about 5 feet short. Or when it was about at 5 feet, I thought it was going to stop rolling. And all I kept thinking was, oh, that's the line. It's just going to be short. But nope. Cash money. Wow, what a putt. That was awesome. That was an awesome moment, guys. I'm glad you were here to watch that. Bears fan, very thank you nice. So much for the follow. I appreciate it. I don't know if you know this, but I'm here every Wednesday night playing this game, streaming this game. So, I appreciate the follow. Be sure to tune in Wednesday nights. I also stream other nights, periodically, other games. I got Overwatch. I got pretty much most games that come out. But this is my one consistent night of streaming endgame. Okay, well, let's try to finish this off with something positive here. I don't want to lose any momentum after that. This wind, these are the winds that drive me crazy. So it's like a 5 o'clock wind, 13 miles an hour. And so I'm like, I don't know how much this is going to affect it. I just had the hardest time gauging that shit. I hope this is there. Oh, it's way right. Jesus, I had the distance at least. God, that was awful. What an awful shot that was. Oh, nice. Live hole in one, man. Those are always good. Well, you should watch more often. Apparently, you're my good luck charm.
All right.
Oh, this.
I'm gonna hop off here now. I gotta play a guy in the MLB, but I'll start just coming up. So.
Ah, no worries, man. Thanks for riding along for 3 hours or for three rounds. 3 hours, I guess. Yeah, two hours, two and a half.
Enjoyed it.
Appreciate it, man.
All right.
Have a good night.
You too.
All right, guys, what do we do here? Shit. Yeah, it's not too bad. Definitely hit it a lot harder than I wanted to, though. Get in there. Yes, I didn't want to give a stroke back. Oh, nice. Really? 88 degrees tomorrow? That sounds amazing. Love it. Where'd you say you're heading to? That'd be a nice little break. It's been 105, 106 a lot lately. It's been really hot the last few weekends. Salem, that's right. I remember you posting that earlier. That's solid, man. That's perfect. I'm at, like I said, I'm going up to Seattle mid-August. No better place to be than the Northwest, like, for 2-3 months of the year. Those summertime months are so good up there. Hey, what's up, Tyler? Welcome to the chat. I'm not sure what I want to do here. What do we got here? 258. Ooh, it's got a good line, you guys. Get rolling. Ooh, this could be a chip. This could be an eagle chip here, guys. little bit uphill. This would be a nice way to end it, wouldn't it? There it is. Go in. Yes! Eagle time, guys. 11 under. Love it. That was a round. One behind Cram there for the lead. Post that bad boy. Yeah, thanks guys. Thanks everyone. It was a good round. Felt good. Let's get this fourth round underway too. Let's hopefully I can get this momentum, keep it going. Post my score. And on to round number four. Well, I'm number 7 on PS4 there. And that includes Smurf, who doesn't count. Well, I don't really know about that. I'm still 9 strokes back. I mean, that's a pretty hefty... I mean, shooting 10 under is a good round. So... I'm just trying to chase John Diesel in there, 32 under, you know? Alright guys, here we go. Round number 4. Boom, and we're off. I mean, I have to go crazy, crazy low. But at this point, you know, if I can get a top 10, I'll be happy. I mean, I shot 8 under that first round. It should have been better, even though actually the 8 under ended up being a good score, considering how I started. So let's hope I can maybe throw up another 10 under, something crazy like that. Put me in the mix. Let's see here. Thing went farther left than I was expecting it to. Oof. Tough putt here. Tough putt. Man, this thing's gonna break a ton. Get in there. Ah. Well. Lame. Parsky. I only Smurf birdied. I guess John Diesel's not even playing anymore. I could probably pop his ghost off. I'll throw the leader on and see where he's at. It's this guy, isn't it? Yeah, there we go. Alright. All right, well, don't go long. I want to be short. These guys all did this, I bet. Shit. Why did that go so far? Ah, this game sometimes. It just really pisses me off. It really does. All right, let's chip it in, shall we? Get it? Yes. Cheers, guys. I'm gonna go fill up my drink. Yeah, it's the only way I know how to do it, though. I just always use the 9-iron, or the 7-iron, or it is a 9-iron, yeah. So I always use the 7-iron, and I know where all the distances are. So, I feel comfortable using it that way. Or do you mean the approach shot? Is that what you're talking about? Yeah, probably. Probably should have just hit it up there, and I mean, I chipped it in, so it worked out, but I would agree with you. I probably got a little too fancy on the approach shot. Ooh, stop. Great. I should probably putt this. Well, we're going to chip it again. Yeah, seriously. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this one. Yeah, I thought that might happen. Damn it. Oof, this is no gimme here. I shouldn't have done a full swing on the chip. That was my fault. Shouldn't have done a full swing. I knew it too. Right when I pulled it back, I was like, this is going to be far. It's going to go too far. God damn it. Get in. Nice little par save there. On the approach shot, you mean, doubtful, or on the chip? This is running uphill at the hole. So I'm into the wind on the chip, yeah. I'm not good at chipping inside those distances. I shouldn't have swung full. That was my problem. I even knew it. I felt like it was going to be too long. I mean, it landed just behind the cup, so. You never know, Griffin. Stop. Griffin won, golfer dude, nothing. Get it. Oh, you son of a bitch. Earn the edge. That's all right. Join the club, golfer dude. We all lose to Griffin. Damn it. Maybe back on the birdie train here. Everybody's 3 under and I'm 1 under. I had a chip that was makeable and I just missed that putt. Oof, you want to be left on this. Nevada throwing darts. Oh, God. This is a very makeable putt uphill, but downhill it's a little different story. Alright, so it's going to break a little bit. I'm going to go right here. Get in there. Yes. Cheers, guys. Oh, that's awesome, man. I kind of feel like I want to go outside after the stream and watch it. There's nothing better than watching monsoons. It's so fucking cool. It's probably a little worse for you up north. Actually, I'll take that back. Usually here in Mesa, it's a little worse. Thanks, Strav. I appreciate it. No, there's no real TGC2 news. I think just for now, it's going to be the announcement with that initial info. And I bet you it'll be a few months before we see anything else, I bet. Which is fine. I feel like the next time I want to see the game, I want it to be a lot closer to being the actual game instead of all this, like, apologizing for what's not in it yet. I mean, I'm glad they showed us what they showed us. I'm not saying that, but, like, I don't need to see any more of it until I have a fucking new avatar and, you know what I mean? Like, things are actually implemented. So I'd rather see it 6 months from now than see it, like, once a month for the next 6 months. Yep, I agree with you, golfer dude. I agree. Yeah, none of the streams lately or none of the information, other than that initial Monday stream, there's been nothing new. Unless people have been posting on the forums, maybe there's been some trickling of information from people answering questions on the forums, possibly. Maybe Keith or AK, but just that one stream. Yeah. And the monthly thing, I guess I wouldn't mind either, but I don't really need to know anymore. I guess what I'm getting at is, the next time I see the game, I'd like to have it be a closer representation of what the game's actually going to be, instead of, like I said, all this stuff that's missing from the build. Yes, that's exactly where I wanted to land it to. Stop. Ooh, keep rolling. Keep rolling. Yeah, that can happen, Yaters. I'm sure at some point somebody's complaining about why there's no ground under repair. This is not as much of a breaking putt as it's trying to look like it is. I think right here is our winner. Just going to depend on how hard I hit it. There it is. Going. Yes. Cheers, guys. Birdie time. Well, let me check real quick, golfer dude. Yeah, it's not raining currently. It's kind of drizzly right now, but it's like, there's water everywhere, so it has been pouring. I just didn't notice it because I got my headphones on, but it has been pouring probably the last half hour, I would bet, or the last hour or so, because it's really, really wet out there. There's a lot of puddles and stuff, but it's currently not actually raining. It's, like, barely drizzling. I was gonna say, don't you stop there. Oh, thank you, Doubtful. Yeah, green beads in their lives, Warrior. That's why I read the grid. Yeah, it's the best I can do for the weather report. This is a tough read here, guys. Ah, I didn't get it up high enough. Damn it. The lying green beads. Yeah, it is hard to hit it that high, because it's just a speed thing, right? I mean, you either make it or you have a 10-footer coming back if you hit it in the right line and right speed. Like it. Tap in. Cheers, guys. Hey, golfer dude. Have a good night, man. Thanks for stopping by and chatting and hanging out. I appreciate it. Maybe I'll see you next week. Have a good trip to Oregon. Travel safe. And, yeah, I'll see you next time. Are we talking about something on the forums, I'm guessing? Is that HB or the TGCTours forums? I mean, come on, wind, really? That's all you're going to pull it? Oh, I mean, I don't feel like the wind even affected the ball that time. It's just so weird. I don't get it. I don't get how it's so inconsistent. Come on, give me another chip in. Ah, not quite. Alright, suggestion box. I'll have to go visit that. So we have been talking about that. I didn't realize that was the same thread you guys have been mentioning. Alright guys, making the turn at 4 under. I'm going to have to get on my horse here. I'd like to get to 10 under. Yeah, Casajas, or Kasja, or however you say that. He's way ahead of me. Uh-oh. Stop, 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 stop. Yes. Right there. Just please stop. Nice. It is Mia Canes. Look at this pin placement. Fuck you, Jimmy. How about that? Get it. Oh, we got it. Yes, birdie time. Cheers, guys. Snuck it on in. I knew Nevada was lurking, just in ninja mode back there, watching his gay porn. You've never watched one of my streams. I whine everywhere. Get in there. Yes. Cheers, everybody. Fair enough, Jimmy, fair enough. Oof. Alright, well, we don't wanna... Alright, try not to be short on this. Thank you. Stop right there, please. Ooh, it did. It did stop. I think I may have had this exact putt last time. Oh, I got it. I was not expecting that because that thing came off the putter face dead right. Nice. I like that. It's a nice little surprise. Cheers, guys. Yeah, seriously. That was the face I made. It was the O face. Now this is going to be a layup. Close ones there. I don't like this as a pitch shot. It's just uphill. I don't know, maybe I will. Let's see what the distance is here. 65 is the distance. That works. Birdie time. Cheers, guys. Yeah, you're probably right. You are probably correct. Ooh, Nevada was close there. Nevada was close. Why was that so short? I don't get this game. I just really don't. Oh well, at least I have a somewhat makeable putt here, but... There we go. Cheers, guys. Does it even have a Stableford format? in this game? I don't play a lot of different stuff, so sorry for my ignorance, but is there even a Stableford option in this game? I think maybe Spieth does. That guy seems to be pretty good at putting. Damn it. Should have hit a better, longer club there. Get in there. Oh, man. So close. God. Oh, go in, go in. It was almost a live one, guys. Almost a live one. That would have been pretty awesome. A good capper for the night, I think. Yes. Cheers, guys. Chipping on in. I'm gonna hit 3-wood. Not even worth hitting driver here. I don't even know, but not worth the risk. Yes, it has. It most definitely has. All right, Yaters. Be close, ball. This is for you, Yaters. Love it. Cheers, guys. I wish I could play that first round again. Uh-oh, that's too far. Whoops. Yeah, thanks Jimmy. It's actually, I enjoyed the course. It's a really fun course. And it's a nice refreshing change from the fast firm nonsense I'm used to playing all the time, so it's good. I liked it a lot. It'd be nice to drain this to end it. Oh, Jesus, I didn't even have enough legs. Well, shit. All right, now I gotta make this. All right, let's end on a bird here, guys. Let's end it on a bird. Nope. That thing broke a lot more than I thought it would. Fuck. Ah, that's disappointing. Oh well. I'll take my 11 under. It's a good scorecard. Look at that back nine. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching tonight's stream. It was a good time. I'm gonna get my score posted here. Yeah, thanks, Yaters. I appreciate it, man. Nevada, good course. Had a good time. Atlanta, thanks for watching. Griffin, I appreciate it. Yeah, there it is. 42 under. Number 5 on the PS4. Smurf plate isn't even there. And there we have it. That is this week's stream. Again, thanks guys for watching. I'll see you next Wednesday. You guys have a good week. Have a safe 4th for those that are celebrating it, assuming you're in the States. And I'll see you next Wednesday. Later, guys.